Today I have a nice rant about collectivism, yes men, propaganda, and Marxism, of course. So I want to talk about the mindset and where the mindset comes from and how everyone just kind of operates in a reactionary way, in a collectivist reactionary way. So the collective cannot be wrong. That is a big part of communism and leftism, is that leftism is always correct. So any idea pushed forth by leftist thought must be correct, because leftism is correct. And the more left you are, the more correct you are, the smarter you are, the better person you are. And then on the other side, the opposite is true. The right wing, all right wing ideas are evil and wrong and stupid, because the right wing is evil and wrong and stupid. So no real discussion can take place, no real thinking or critical thinking can take place. And this is all by design. This has all been seeded into your psyche by the ruling class and by propaganda. Now, you may ask yourself, why would the ruling class choose the left wing as the intelligent, the righteous, the saintly, and the right wing as evil, stupid, redneck, racist, yada, yada, yada? You could go on forever with the insults. And it's quite obvious. Marxism and left-wing ideas consolidate power in the state, and they consolidate power among the ruling class and among the rich. So obviously the rich and the ruling class have an agenda and have an incentive to embed these ideas into the public through the television, through the news media, through fake news. So these ideas, or dare I say, emotional directives, are pushed into the minds of the masses over and over and over again for decades. And then the collective rewards itself by reinforcing these ideas amongst each other over and over and over again. And of course, these ideas can't be challenged and they can't be wrong, because everyone believes them, right? And anyone who questions the ideas, anyone who thinks, is attacked by the collective mercilessly and ostracized and called racist and bigot and evil and all of these other things, because the members of the collective are responding to their programming. They're reacting to their programming like NPCs. And that is the source of the meme, and that's why the meme has resonated so well amongst the internet. So you end up with a society where no one is able to think and no one is able to have new ideas. And this, because everyone gets shouted down if they do have ideas. And this goes on and on and on. It reinforces itself because the media reinforces it and the news reinforces it. And everyone you see on television, the talking heads reinforce it, violently so. And therefore, all of the thinking, all of the critical thinking, all of the debate, all of the new ideas are relegated to people who are not afraid of being shouted down, are not afraid of the label of right wing. And so the right wing has all of the new ideas, has all of the sophisticated intellectual debate, and the left wing just becomes this this collectivist programming that just is an engine just cycling and revving, going nowhere. And so if you really want to have a actual debate, an actual conversation about ideas and judge the ideas, you can't categorize the ideas into a binary, into this collectivist thinking. The ideas have to stand on their own, independent of any ideology, independent of any groupthink or propaganda. And how would you describe arcology and the social contract and all of these things that I've put forth? They're unique and novel ideas, but you can't really put them in a category. They are designed to assist society and improve society, and they are beyond the scope of the binary and beyond the scope of the propaganda, because the propaganda doesn't even know they exist, and they don't want you to know they exist, because these are ideas that help the people. These are the ideas that help society. And the propaganda apparatus is completely self-serving. All of their agendas are completely self-serving. And this is something that people have a very, very difficult time with. The idea and admitting that the ruling class doesn't really care about you, doesn't really have your best interests at heart. They have their own best interests at heart. And this is something that I think the left and the progressives and that crowd really has a hard time wrapping their head around, that they've been led astray, that they've been hoodwinked and bamboozled. Like that Mark Twain quote says, "It is easier to fool someone than to convince them that they have been fooled." So that is the lesson of this video, ladies and gentlemen, is to think about ideas and consider ideas independent of ideology, completely independent of the box that you're putting your adversary in, and really consider how they will help greater society and how they will help humanity, not just you, not just your own lived experience, but humanity as a whole. And break away from the dogma, especially when the dogma is shown to only help the ruling class and only help the state, and when the entire lesson of the 20th century history is one of the dangers of the state and the damage and destruction and how state power or the thirst for state power can create hell on earth for the majority of mankind. Just to hand wave away all of that and to dismiss all of that, and then to propagate ideas that assist the ruling class and solidify the power and control of the ruling class is really, really shameful. And everyone who does this needs to take a step back and have some self-awareness and ask yourself, are these ideas my own, and are these ideas the best thing for my community? And be open to new ideas, be open to things that are outside of the dogma, instead of immediately calling them dangerous right-wing extremism and all of these things. Maybe step back and actually consider them, and consider the person who is championing them. Ask yourself if they are your peer, if you are closer to them than you are to the ruling class trying to push Marxism and totalitarianism onto the population. So we need to drop the ideological war, the ideological dogma, and actually have real discussions about real ideas and real solutions that are novel to the political and economic scene. Anyway, that's it. Thank you, and have a nice day.
It's over. Nobody wins.
If you want to see a new and better world come to fruition, as I do, then like, share, and subscribe. You can find an incredible amount of math, knowledge, and 3D renders by clicking on the channel name. And remember, we need you to help spread this vision across the internet for all to see and become familiar with. Let us build this new world together.